Hi guys, and welcome back to Wade's Workshop. So this is going to be the Webster engine part 4, and we're going to do the blocking up and drilling and what have you of the conrod. The next episode 5 will be the rotary table work on the conrod. It's quite a lot of machining in this part, so I've had to split it into 2 episodes, otherwise we'd be sat here watching this for an hour, so we don't want to be doing that. So that said, I have actually dropped the mini lathe project temporarily, but I haven't forgotten about it. It is on the back burner there, and I will be getting back to that at some stage, not in the not too distant future. And I have actually got another little project that I am filming that is running alongside this engine. It is a much smaller project, but I am doing more work as well alongside it with various other bits and pieces. There's a lot going on here in the shed. I'm feeling a lot better. The cold is a lot better. So anyway, enough yabber. Let's get on with this conrod. So, conrod. I have blocked up the 2 blocks. Well, there's only 1 conrod, but I'm actually going to make 2. Not because I'm building 2 engines. I'm not doing a matty. But on the grounds that I've been cocking things up lately, if I make 2, at the point where I cock the first one up, I've got a backup that's up to that stage. So, yeah, there's a lot of procedures in here. So, overall length, 3.532. It's actually 3.16 thick at the moment. It's got to be 3.13. And the width of this is 563. So I blocked 2 up. So, first hole, big end, we're going to call it. Drawing calls for a 3/8 reamed hole to put a bronze bush in. I'm actually going to put a needle bearing in here, and the needle bearings I've got are a 6mm ball, and they're 10mm OD, and they'll fit within this thickness. So I'm going to drill and ream 10mm, and the distance in is 0.5563, 2.81½. So I've centered it up, moved in 2.81½, stopped there. Everything's set against the stop. I did set it on a parallel, and I've taken the parallel out. So drill and ream 10mm. So I'm just going to take it gently, do both holes in this one, then put the other one up and go on the same datums if everything works well. You know, that center drill doesn't feel very good. I do need to buy some center drills, guys. I do need to. A little bit of rust on there. One end of this isn't right, the sound of it. That feels better. Okay, just start that off. So I think I'll put a 6mm drill in first. Let's bring the head up a bit. That's the right way. Then I'm going to swap to a 9.5 drill, and then put the 10mm reamer through. Oops. So 6mm drill. How does that look? Let's just slow it down a tiny bit, maybe. I don't know. Not pushing too hard, there's no parallel under here. I have got the vise tight. Okay, so a 6mm drill. So swap that out now. Let's just remove the chuck collet nut. Pull him out of the way. I've got 9.5 drill, collet, 10mm collet, and a collet nut here. I'm going to wind in a bit because it's a 9.5 drill and a 10mm collet. Have I got enough height there? Probably not. Just come down the top. Should be enough to get the reamer in as well. Just slow that down, just peck that through. So that's a 9.5 drill. So before doing any further machining on these, I'm going to put both holes in, and I know they're on the same plane to each other. So drawing does say to do that, but yeah, it makes perfect sense anyway. So my chuck I use all the time here takes up to a quarter. So when I go bigger than a quarter, which I am in this case, I have to take the chuck out. I have got a larger chuck, but it takes up a lot of headroom. I probably should get myself a nice chuck that does 10 mil perhaps. 3/8 chuck maybe. Maybe I'll buy myself one for Christmas, a little 3/8 Rome chuck instead of this one. This one's a quarter, or 0 to 6.5. Probably do 0 to, probably do up to 10.5. So let's slow that reamer. Now hopefully, well, I'm going to be Loctite in the little bearing in, but hopefully this leaves a good hole. Again, this reamer's had a fair bit of use. I'm not going to go right up the reamer shank. Okay, so let me just get one of those bearings out and I can so that should not, that's the little needle roller bearing, should not fall through there. It doesn't. Okay, I'm going to leave it at that. I can just push it in there at a later stage, much later stage. So, I'm going to step across now. I've got everything set on zero on my DRO, and my hole centres are 3.063, and in much the same style, quarter reamed hole in the other end. And I'll do that for both parts. So 10mm reamed hole that end, quarter reamed hole that end, centres are correct. Looks close there, but it is 3/16 in, so yeah, it was 0.1875 in with a quarter reamed hole. Anyway, that's another story. I think I'll, yeah, let me just, wondering about giving myself just a, you'll put an X on there, just to show top. Don't know why. No reason. Okay, so this was set up against a stop. Put that one to one side. Now then, let's clean this vise out. Let's just have a look down in there. Nothing in the bottom. No, we're good. Right, that's nice clean parallel that I used first of all. Pop him back in. Find the second aluminium bar which I've put down somewhere. Oh, it's dropped down in that groove. Would you believe that? Oh, come on. So the second part has dropped down in that T-slot. Of course, it won't come out this way and it can't go out that way. And I'm struggling to get hold of it here. I have got some very small, I think I've got a, oh well, that was lucky. Anyway, yeah, oh what fun. So I'm thinking about the mode of operations on this. Now there's a step between, there's two, okay, let me get something pointy-ish. So there's going to be a full rad on the end of here, and it actually continues on round to a point. But then at a depth of 31 thou, it goes all the way round, so it leaves like a circular spigot on the top here. But the rest of it is machined away. Now these two sides at some point are going to be tapered down to the small end. I'm going to make a jig for that going forward. But when I machine around the top. It's going to be rotary table work. I want to just relieve the bit that doesn't need to be done on a rotary table. So again, I'm tapped down on a parallel this time. I'm still on the same stop, and I've marked in a line on both ends that are probably a millimeter closer together. You know, that there's leaving a millimeter of meat on. So I've already set the zero. Let me just confirm my zero. Yeah, maybe half thou. Okay, so I'm going to go 32 thou deep, because this thickness, overall thickness, is a little bit thick anyway, by 3 or 4 thou. So let's do 10 thou cuts, I think. So set zero on my X. Okay. So I'm going to do this to depth this end. Same the other end. Cutter could be going a bit faster. That's 31. Oh, that's 32 pounds. Okay, I'll just back off on that. Let me just move across now. Get somewhere near my line on the other end. And I'll have some reference marks, so I can just do the same readings on the other side. And then, okay, a bit closer. Let's get a bit of depth in there. Okay, about there. That's 26 deep. Thirty-two. Okay, so I'll just back off that, maybe to 10 thou. 2.205. So I'm going to write that down. 2.205, and that end is zero. That will wipe straight off my vise. And I do have a use of power feed for this, eh? I do have the video for reference. If it does rub off. I'm bumping the tripod. Sorry, guys. It's right by where my controllers are for the power feed. Okay. Just machining this away between the two slots we just did. Okay, let's go down. 2060. So I've got to do this on both sides. So I'll basically, when I finish this side, flip it 180. With this side down in the vise, with the thick ends on the parallel, and machine exactly the same slot, same dimensions, same datums on the other side. Okay, right, we have we're at 27 deep. So let's finish it off to depth. I just wound the handwheel and I ended up on. Okay, so I think I'll do stripes on here. just less than a cutter thickness with every pass. It's all going to be polished up anyway. I don't know why I'm worrying too much, but cutter's cutting really nicely. I went with a smaller cutter. Don't know why. Just easier to control, I suppose. So, side one done. I think I'll just check myself. That should be greater than, well, it's 586 and it has to be greater than 563. Good. And that is 432 and it has to be greater than 375. Okay, could probably go a little bit more on this one, but yeah, it's fine. So I'm going to do those settings. I'm losing my references. 2.205. You get the picture. I'll take that one out. Do the same on the second one. Deburr this while I'm machining it, and then we'll flip the two. Or do I do it all on one in case I mess up? I'm going to do it all on the first one. And that way, if I check it all out at the end and something's wrong, I haven't messed them both up. I'm just checking my own sanity here. Ooh. Two four seven and a half. Well, I was aiming at 250. I mean, it's okay. It's okay. But 247, yeah, okay. What I'll do is, when I do the second one here, I'll, instead of going 32 thou deep, I'll go 31 thou deep, and hopefully we'll get to where we're supposed to be. So, I mean, it'll make a good backup if I'm going to call this one the primary, this one here. I'm going to use this one to learn from mistakes and this one to be the finished part. So I've already found a use for this in that I went too deep on that. Okay, well, you know, it was a thou aside, but happy days. So let's see how we did with the second one. Whoop. Well, 249.5. Okay, that's better. Right, that's two of those. I'm going to put an X on the good one. Good one, they're both good, but on the good one. And we're going to move on to the next phase. So, when I cut the radius on here, obviously there's going to be a full circle on the top bit, on this unstepped bit. I want to have a run out into this semicircle, which was a quarter radius, so I've got, or eighth radius. So I've used a quarter cutter. So basically, I knew that I had to step in with an offset from centre of basically an offset with that cutter of 303 thou. So I knew that much, but I didn't know which distance away from this centre where the intersect of that quarter is going to hit. So I basically pecked in just the top bit, which doesn't matter at this stage, and worked my way in slowly, a couple of thou at a time, until I got the correct wall thickness there. So I think it was about 88 thou, something like that, bearing in mind I've got a 10 mil hole in. So once they got that, just the top bit, which I'd pecked away to get the correct wall thickness, I could then do a series of pecks in to my 304 datum and back out again. So I'll show you on the other side. So that's a better spot. So I've set a stop on my quill. My X is locked. So I basically come in till I get a touch. So this is the run out for the rotary table work and the intersection with the eighth radius into the flat. It's actually going to be a tapered flat. So my offset is 304 from centre at finish. So just pecking my way in. It's the simplest way with not having any load on this. There's 101 ways I could have done this, but this just happens to be the one I went with. Nearly there now. About 4 or 5 thou to go. My actual reading was about 303,000, but I'm going 304. Okay, so that's the intersection point between where I do the rotary table work and where the tapered flats are going to be, where the flat basically intersects. So that's that bit done. Happy with that. So yeah, dimension wise it's not going to be smack on drawing spec. I mean, I could have worked it out with CAD, but it's going to be pretty close to where it should be. So that's that one. Now I need to do a similar thing the other end. So I'll have to work out what the thickness is down this end. Work out what the thickness is, and then I can I'll basically have the 1.5 degree taper. So I'll probably have to measure a length between there, that intersection, and the one the other end to get the 1.5 degree taper. Another way I can do it, yeah, there's a few ways I can do this. I'm sort of losing track of where I am a bit and how I explain it, but you get the picture. So I've got a dimension now. I can do the same thing on the other one and then flip it, practice on the one that I don't mind if I ruin, and we'll get there. So I'm going to try and explain it a bit better. Just pecking the top surface, I know my offset in Y is going to be 239, so I'm pretty sure I'm well off at the moment. I'm going to come into 239. Oop, too far. Come on. Okay. So that's 239 offset. So I'm going to wind off that. I'm just going to set a zero in X. So bring you out the way, I'm afraid. Right, now I'm going to measure the wall with my calipers, which I've hidden under my book. Measure the wall thickness between the bore and the OD. And that wall thickness, I'm going to have to wind out a bit more, needs to be a set figure, the intersection point. Right, that's 112 at the moment. Let me write that down. So I need to work out what that wall thickness should be when it's finished. So if I just get the drawing out, I should have done this before. I'll bring you back in a sec. So the size I was looking for was a 16th. So I'm just going to go 62 thou. So I'll just peck a little bit more off, because I was up in the hundreds. I've just taken 10 thou, I'll take some more. Into my 239. It's not linear this, so 10 thou wouldn't reduce that by 10 thou. We're on a like a 45 degree angle in there. So I'm just going to bring this wall thickness down. 88. And I'm looking for 62. Another 10 thou. Okay. Just working my way into it. 239 again. Okay, patience is the order of the day. I mean, I could have probably worked it out with trig. 75. I'll just keep setting them zero in X. I'm going to go 5 thou. That won't take 5 thou off it. Into 239. But once I got the datum, I've got it. There we go. And I'll know where it is. Obviously my measurement isn't deadly accurate, but 75, okay, I can go another 5. We're very nearly there, I would have thought. It's just 65 thou. I'm going to take another 2 off there. And I think we're going to call it at that. Into 239. I think we're going to be on it. So that gives me the correct wall thickness on the end. It's hardly made a difference, 65. Yeah, okay, you get the idea. Just, it gives me a guide of when I'm on that intersection point where it should be. So I got this this stage and realised I could have done it a lot easier than this, but this is where I am. So to get the 1.5 degree degree angle on here, I've got a 10mm hole and I've got a quarter hole. So what I did, obviously those are a fixed distance, so that's the hypotenuse of a triangle. So I know the angle needs to be 1.5 degrees, it's 3 degrees inclusive, so 1.5 degrees a side. So simple sine, so 3.063, worked it out, sine of the angle of 1.5 times 3.063 gives me what the height difference is. Obviously I have also added in the difference in height between 5mm radius and 8th radius. And added that to my shim pile. So they're not shims, they're slip gauges. It worked out at 3.901. So I've got a stack of slips in there on the parallel on top of the vise. And I've got the whole part tapped down onto there on the two diameters and on there, and clamped onto a sacrificial backing plate, which is just a chunk of aluminium in the vise. And away to go. Now I've just done the backside, and it worked out nice, as it turned out. It cleared up on the bottom of my holes almost, you know, within nothing. I couldn't see. I would have stopped cutting. I got to my numbers. I stopped cutting this end, went over here, and it was, yeah, absolutely spot on. So, Sometimes you win on these things, but I'm sure I could have found a far easier way to do this. I mean, probably the easiest way would have been to dowel it on with a 10mm dowel and a 6mm dowel onto a plate, square the plate all up, put two holes in it, the right distances, and then put a 1.5 degree angle on the bottom of the plate. That probably would have been the easiest way to do it. And then obviously I could have sat the plate down on a parallel and machined the two sides and just flipped apart. That would have been far easier. But this is the way I've gone, so... Yeah. So that's where we're at so far. Radiuses came out, blended into the sides quite nicely. I've just run a needle file over the top and what have you, just to tidy it up and move the, take the burrs off the corners. But yeah, it's coming along. Rotary table work next, I think. Well, I think that's enough machining for today, and in the next episode we'll be doing, as I said earlier on, doing the rotary table work on the ends of the conrod. So looking forward to doing that, and not looking forward to messing it up, because there's a lot of time invested in this part so far. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for subscribing, and we'll see you all very soon. Cheers now.